Hi, Matt Morris here. Welcome to another episode of the Unemployed Millionaire Show, the entrepreneur's guide to lifestyle freedom. Again, here in sunny Cyprus on the Mediterranean Sea, sitting outside the Four Seasons here. Just a picture-perfect day. And wanted to talk about a subject that I really hold dear, and it's one of the things that I think is just absolutely mandatory if you really want to achieve massive, massive success in your life. And here's the deal. By yourself, you can get a certain amount of things done, but there's only so much you can do as one individual. And so what is the number one skill that can take your success and multiply it many, many times over? And I believe what that characteristic is leadership. And so one of the things that I go into a lot of detail in my book, my favorite chapter in the whole book is chapter 7, where we go into the laws of leadership. And what I'm going to do here is do kind of a several part episode. We'll chunk it up here so it's not too long, but I really want to kind of delve into leadership. We haven't really done a whole lot of shows on leadership so far. And so here's one of the, you know, number one traits or one of the rules, I guess you would say, of leadership, and that's this, is other people want to follow a leader that they perceive as a higher level of leader than themselves. And it's you got to be careful with the way that I worded that. You got to listen very carefully, because what I said is other people want to follow someone that they perceive as a greater level leader. Now, that word that I said is perceive, perception. So what is leadership? In reality, what leadership is, in many cases, is just a perception. And one of the rules that I kind of live by is leadership is assumed, it's not granted. And so there's a lot of, you know, if you look at corporate America, the traditional corporate world, someone is promoted to a leader, and they may have the position or they may have the title, but their people may not necessarily look at them as a leader. So I would consider that to be a manager, not a leader. And so leadership is something that's assumed. It's something that is taken, if you will, if I can be so bold as to use a word like that. But, you know, one of the things that I struggled with when I was young, I'm 33 years old now, and, you know, no longer feel like the young guy anymore. And I was about 24 years old, and I was building a sales team and started a company, and, you know, just on and on. And I had this thing, this recurring thing in my mind, that I knew that I needed to be a great leader in order to get what I wanted in life, but I had this conversation running in my mind that I was somehow too young to be a leader. And I had not experienced a ton of success in my life, so I really didn't feel like I could own that for myself. And I had a mentor of mine who, you know, I really looked up to, and I was always talking about how much I admired him and asking him questions. And he was one of these guys that could get in front of a room and just awe the crowd. You know, they would hang on every word that he said. He was the best salesperson I'd ever met. And, you know, as I'm kind of edifying him and all this, he says, "Matt, do you know why I'm such a great salesperson?" And I didn't really know. He said, "Do you know why I'm so good on stage? Do you know why that I'm a great leader?" And I didn't know the answer. And I said, "Well, you've had a lot of success." He said, "That has nothing to do with it. Why am I a great leader?" And I answer the question. He said, "I'm a great salesperson because I believe, I'm confident that I can, you know, sell something. I can lead people because I'm confident I can lead them. I can speak on stage because I'm confident I can speak on stage." And, you know, that I still didn't make the connection in my mind. I said, "Well, you know, Wayne, you're, you know, a great salesperson because you've learned all this stuff." And he said, "No, it all comes down to confidence. And it wasn't that I developed confidence because I became good. No, I became good because I was confident." And so many of us live in a matter of, you know, once I have the results, I'll become the person. And in reality, you're never going to become the person until you become, you're never going to have the results until you become the person. So it's one of those, it's not have and then become, it's you become, and because you become, then you get to have the results. And so I kind of flipped it in my mind, and I said, "You know what, I'm going to assume the leadership. I'm going to just project my confidence. I'm going to speak at a, you know, faster pace. I'm going to kind of project my voice. I'm going to shake hands with, you know, more authority than I have in the past. I'm going to stand taller, and I'm just going to constantly tell myself that I am the leader that every other leader is looking for. And that was my mantra for a long time, and I kind of, you know, mentally faked it till I made it. And what happened is, all of a sudden, because I just assumed that confidence and assumed that leadership and projected the confidence, people started telling me what a great leader I was, even before I fully believed it in myself. And so it's one of the characteristics of a leader. Don't think in your mind that you have to have amazing results before you can become a leader, because you're never going to have amazing results until you become that leader. And so just take it upon yourself to become the leader. And what I'm going to go through on the next few segments here are the laws of leadership. And this is in the book here, chapter number 7, the laws of leadership. So we're going to pop into number 1 here on the next show.